Hello friend, welcome back to my lecture on database connectivity. So it is in the continuation of the previous lecture. So in previous lecture I have described you the all aspects and all commands of database connectivity, connectivity with Oracle, connectivity with MS Access, SQL, and prepared statement, execute query, execute update, so result set, and lots of command I have discussed in previous lectures. So today I am discussing with JDBC, Java Database Connectivity, with storing image in database and result set manipulation, as well as result set metadata. So metadata means data about data. So I will cover in this lecture all the these topics. So first of all, how to store image in the database. So I will discuss about this image, how to store image in the database. So this is my first program. So you can see here the program is started by the import java.sql, then java import java.io. So basically we are storing or retrieving image, we are storing image in the database. So previously we can store fields like character, we can store number value, we can store boolean value, but we have not learned about how to store images. So in this program we can store the images. So the first two statements are the same. So from third statement onward we have to we are storing here the image. So these statements are the same statement as we have learned the previous lectures in the previous slides. So this is class.forName. We are using here driver manager. Through class.forName command we are storing the driver, oracle.jdbc.driver.oracle-driver. And then we have second command, that is connection command, connection con equals to driver manager dot get connection. So by doing this second command we are creating the connection. So here jdbc colon oracle colon thing. So this is the connection string, and inside this collect we have been localhost oracle colon thin, and localhost 1521 is the port name, and user, this is user ID, and this is password. So these two statements are defined in the previous lecture also. So now the third statement, that is prepared statement, its object is ps, and connection dot create prepared statement. So this is the function, this is the method, prepare statement method, and this method is under connection class. So con is the object of this connection class. So this command and this function will execute this insert command, insert into employee table value, and we have given two question mark, means we'll input input these two values through user. So this is for user input, the question mark first and question mark second, and ps is the object of this insert command. So we have been the reference ps. So we'll write here ps dot set string. So we have to input the first question mark at the position of first question mark. So we will write here ps dot set string first in the one means first question mark, and we are storing here Ashok. So this name is will be stored here in the first question mark. So it means we have this employee table, and inside employee table we have two fields. This first question mark is for the first table, and second question mark is for the second table. And now this ps.set string, and we are storing at first position Ashok, and in second position, this command is for the second position. So you can see here the heading, to store image in the database we use in binary form. So image will be stored in the form of the binary. So we will write here one more class, file input stream, and its object is fin. File input stream fin equals to new file input stream, and here we will mention the name of image file. So this abc.image, so this is abc.image is inside desktop and inside Shubham. So this is the path name, path of this abc.jpg, means under C drive we have user directory, and under user directory we have sudo directory, and under sudo directory we have desktop directory, and under desktop directory we have abc.jpg. So this image, through file input stream, we are importing this image, and the object of this reference of this image is fin. So we are writing here in the second column, in the second question mark. You can see here this image will be stored in the binary form. To store the image in the database, we use binary form. So we'll write here ps.setBinaryStream. However, in the previous one, the first question mark is stored by the it is input by setStream. While here we'll write setBinary. So in place of setString, we'll write here setBinaryStream. And at second question, fin is the object of this abc.jpg image. So this is fin, and fin.available we are giving here third argument, fin.available. It will return true or false. If it is available, then the command will run. So this is the boolean type. It's written type with the boolean type. So by this command we will store at second position the fin, and fin having abc.jpg image. And then after mentioning these first Ashok and Ashok's image, and after mentioning the name and its image, then we are writing here ps.executeUpdate. So this is executeUpdate command, ps.executeUpdate, and ps is the object of the prepared statement, and ps having insert command, insert into emp values are this values question mark means user input. So ps.executeUpdate. So in case of select query, we'll write here ps.executeQuery. While we are writing here insert command, so we'll mention here the function name of the execution, ps.executeUpdate. So integer I equals to ps.executeUpdate, and this is system.out.println success, and connection.close, and then catch statement, catch exception e, e dot print stack trace. So in case of any exception, suppose while running or these statement, suppose any exception generates, so this catch statement will execute, and print stack trace will display the message accordingly. So this is the image input program. Now the second topic of this lecture. So as I told you, the first topic is storing image in the database, and second one is the result set manipulation. So second one is result set manipulation. However, we have not mentioned here result set in this program because we are using here insert command. So in case of select query, we will use result set. You can see in the previous lectures program. So in previous lecture we have result set. So you can see here, this is the class dot for name. We are loading the driver here, and this is connection cun equals to driver manager dot connection, get connection, and then connection string. And third one is the statement st equals to connection dot create statement. So we are writing here blank statement. Then we are writing here result set rs equals to st.executeQuery, and select st from student. So by this statement we are selecting all the data of student table, and the object is rs, because when this will return all the data, and this data will be saved on rs. So rs.next, so this loop will be execute up to the statement inside the student table. Suppose student table having 10 record, so this while loop will run 10 times, and this rs.next function will return 10 true value. The for first line it will return 2, for second line it will return 2, and up to 10th line it will return true. And after 10th line we don't have any record, then it will return false, and will come out from this while loop. So this is result set. So I am talking about this result set. So I have mentioned here about the result set. Result set manipulation. So how we will manipulate the result set? This is in this piece of program. So you can see here statement stmt equals to connection dot create statement. So after loading the driver, then we will create second statement, connection statement, and after creating the connection statement, this is the third statement where we are creating the statement stmt equals to connection dot create statement. So you can see here results are dot type scroll insensitive. Type scroll insensitive means it will not scroll backward direction. It will move only. Type scroll insensitive. Insensitive means it can move forward and backward of both direction. And results are dot concur read only. So it means we can only read, we cannot update the data through result set. So this is the result set class, and these are the constant variable. So we are passing as a argument to the create statement, and we have this queries string query equals to select student from class where type not sleeping. So we have given here where clause and type equals to not sleeping. So it will return all the records whose type is not sleeping. So this is the third statement, string query equals to select student from class where type equals to not sleeping. And this is the result set RS equals to statement dot execute query, and we will execute this query. So result set RS equals to statement dot execute query. This is the statement, and statement dot execute query. Query is this, we have stored this query. So it will execute this query. So you can see here RS dot previous means it will move to the previous record. Go back in RS. If we will not use this function, and then it is not possible to go back. So RS dot relative minus 5 means it will move 5 record back. And relative 7, it means it will move, go 7 record forward. And RS dot absolute 100, go to 100's record. Absolutely means 100, absolute function will move to exactly at record number 100. So by using these commands, previous, relative and absolute command, we can move forward and backward in the result set. So this is create statement. By we will have to mention here create statement type scroll insensitive. So we can scroll insensitive means if we can move forward as well as backward. And concur read only means we can read only, we cannot change them. So only we are reading here, we are displaying the record. And this is query. Query is select testing from table name. Select student, name of student from class. So class is a name of table. Student is the field. But where not sleeping. So condition, the type is not sleeping. So all students who are not sleeping, their record will be returned. So this is query. We have stored query by in this query variable, and we are running here execute query. This by using this execute query function, we are running this query. So after running the query, all the record will be transferred to the RS. And RS dot previous means one record back. RS dot relative means one record, five record back. RS dot relative 7 means we will move forward, go to 7th record, 7 record forward. We will jump by 7 record. And absolute 100 means, RS dot absolute 100 means exactly we will move to the record number 100. So RS dot, so RS is the object of result set class. So this is scrolling result set. And I have given one more example where we are writing here type forward only. So in case of insensitive, in case of type scroll insensitive, we will move forward as well as backward. While in case of the type forward only, we will move only forward direction, will not backward direction, will not move backward direction. So this is second argument, result set dot concur updatable. So here we can update the record also, but in the previous one, concur read only is, it means concur read only, it means we can display the record, we can read, we can read the record, and while we can update as well, record can be updated here. So the query, again you can see the query, select student, we are selecting student as well as grade, while in the previous one we are selecting only students. So here we are using students as well as grade from class where type really listening in the presentation. So this is the type, the student who are really listening to the presentation. So it will return all the student and their grade. So we have stored this query in this query variable, and we are executing here execute query, the above stored query. So statement stmt.execute query and argument is query, and it will return to the rejection. And we are writing here while rs.next. We will use here while rs.next. So while loop will run and it will move only forward direction. We have written here type forward only. So this is in capital letter. Basically these variable are the constant variable. So we have mentioned here rs.getInteger grade. So we are when this loop will run first time, so it will first time it will return the grade of first student. So rs.getInteger grade. So the grade of first student, first student's grade, it will return rs.getInteger grade, grade of first student, and it will be stored on grade variable. And then rs.updateInteger, by getInteger we are getting the grade, and by updateInteger we are changing the grade of student by adding 10 on existing grade. So grade is the field, and on grade field we are adding grade plus 10. So existing grade plus 10. Suppose the first grade is 5, then we are adding 5 plus 10, 15. Its grade will be 15. So we have updated by this value. And finally we'll write rs.update row. Only this line is not sufficient to update the field. We have to mention rs.update row. So when we execute this line, so it will update the row. So by this way we can update the record also. So the ResearchHelp is capable to display the data of each line, as well as it can update the it can update the field. Each field can be updated also. So this is the first program where we can move forward and move backward, and here we are updating. So existing grade we are returning, get integer means we are returning the existing grade of the first line, first row, first student of this select, and then we are storing it into a variable, and then updating this grade by adding 10. And finally we write here update. So this is the second. So this is the second topic of my lecture, result set manipulation. And finally I will describe you result set metadata. So this is the third one, result set metadata. So you can see here result set metadata, basically data about data. So public static void print rs, so this is the name of function, and result set rs is the argument of this print rs function. And throw SQL exception, in case of any error, in case of SQL, it will throw the exception. So the program is started by here and it will close by here. This is the function, basically not complete program. So we have mentioned here result set metadata. So not all, we are not writing here only result set. In the previous class we are mentioning here result set class, but here we have been result set metadata, and MD its object rs.getMetadata. So by using this function rs.getMetadata, so it will return all the detail of the result set, rs result set, rs.getMetadata, rs is the object of result set. So getMetadata is data about data, so it will return the data which is used in the result set. So it will return all the information about that data. So get number of column. So inside rs, inside result set, how many columns we have, so it will return by get column count. So md.getcolumn, so md is the object of result set metadata. So it will return all the columns of md. So integer n calls is the variable, and suppose we have been 5 columns, so it will return 5 on n calls. So we are running here for integer I equals to 1, I less than n calls on plus plus I. So if this loop will execute 5 times, and 5 times will execute, and 5 times this system.out.println will execute, and it will display the, all the name of column. So get column name, so name of all the column, md.get column name I. So the I means first, so first column name, then second column name. So get column count will return the count of column, and get column name will return name of column. name of each column. So md dot get column name I, get column name g1, get column name 2, get column name 3, 4. So accordingly it will display all the column names. And this is while dot r, while rs dot next. So this while loop will execute, and rs dot next will move one by one to the next record. And again inside this we have been for loop, and in the first column, in the first row, it will for first row, suppose in the first row we have been 5 filled, so it will execute 5 times for each row. So n call, suppose 5, so it will execute 5 times for each row. So rs dot get string, it will return all the values of the particular column. So initially we have been I is 1, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 5 column will return, and finally it will return get string and calls. So this way this metadata will return data about the data. So this is the program, and I have explained you result set metadata and how to store image on the database, as well as result set manipulation. So I hope you understand all the things, and but learning these things along with learning of these things, you must have to practical on it, on this database connectivity. So everything is given on this era of this technology, everything is given on net, and you can take help of different programs also, and maybe there may be some easier program on your on the web. So you have been different mode of learning, so I suggest you to do practical on this database connectivity, then you will understand this database connectivity in a better way. So thank you guys, thank you very much.